Let's be honest, most building handover feels like someone threw documents into a box and just walked away. Manuals, random PDF, as-built drawings, maybe a USB drive, and good luck figuring it out later. But here's what nobody tells you. The real cost of building isn't building it, it's in operating it. And when your handover is a mess, that cost grows bigger. So that's where COBie comes in. It's a smarter, structured, searchable way to hand over a building. And today we'll break it down. So before BIM and COBie, the handover process looked like this. Drawings rolled up and handover physically. Equipment details stored in folders. Maintenance history in a separate register. So all this information are essential, but it is scattered, inaccessible, and outdated the moment the building starts operating. So when something broke down, let's say a fire alarm panel, the facility management team had to go on a treasure hunt. So where is it located? Who installed it? Is it under warranty? What's the manual say? So people often think we gave them as-built drawings, that should be enough. But here's the truth. As-built only show what was constructed. They don't show how to operate or maintain it. They don't tell you who installed it or the warranty info. They don't help you locate where spare parts are or operational documents. As-built captures physical information, but they add very little to the operational value. Operating a building for 30 years often costs 3 to 5 times more than building it. So while we obsess over design precision and construction schedules, we often leave facility team in the dark. So this is where COBie comes in. COBie stands for, what does COBie stands for? Let me Google it.
2,000 years later.
So COBie stands for Construction Operations Building Information Exchange. So yeah, it is a way to hand over structured digital data to facility teams. It's usually delivered as an Excel file or embedded into an IFC model. But more than the format, it's the intent that matters. So COBie answers, what asset is installed? Where is it? Who installed it? What's the maintenance schedule? What documents or warranties are attached? So in other words, it brings together all the info you need to run the building and not just build it. So what's inside a COBie file?
A typical COBie file has these tabs. Starting from facility, floor, space type. It includes location related info, type, component. It has details related to what is installed. The system, it is about how assets are connected, and there are other tabs, which is contact, document, warranty, spare. Everything you need to maintain it.
So it's like giving the facility management team a control panel, not just a pile of drawings. Imagine a hospital ICU loses cooling and there is some problem in the HVAC system. So with COBie, the facility management team can instantly identify the component, check if it is under warranty, pull up the manual, and call the right vendor. That's faster repair, less risk, and real money saved. And it's not just about comfort or cost, it's also about safety. A missed maintenance task on a fire suppression system, emergency lighting, or medical equipment could literally be life-threatening. Timely maintenance isn't optional, it's critical. So COBie makes sure no equipment is forgotten because everything is tracked, scheduled, and accessible. You multiply that across hundreds of assets and COBie becomes a major cost saver and risk reducer. But let's be real, COBie isn't a magic button. Here are the practical challenges team faces. Number one, lack of awareness or training. Teams don't know how to map or use COBie. Number two, unclear BEP requirements. If the BIM execution plan doesn't clearly state what COBie data is required for, like which asset, what parameters, and what stage, everyone interprets it differently. This leads to either missing data or inconsistencies across disciplines. Number three, too much or too little data. Sometimes teams overload the COBie sheet with unnecessary details, making it hard to use. Whereas sometimes they leave out critical information like warranty, dates, or serial number. Finding the right balance is the key here. Number four, no facility management involvement. If the facility management team isn't involved early in the project, no one really knows what they'll need during operations. As a result, the COBie data might be technically correct, but practically useless for the people actually running the building. And number five, last minute rush. COBie is treated as a formality, not a process in many projects. COBie is treated as a last minute handover checklist. Teams start filling it in just before the project closeout. By then, it's too late to gather a reliable or accurate data. So the quality suffers and the value is lost. So, all right. Have you worked on a project with COBie or experienced a messy handover? Let me know in the comments. Like this video if it helped you and subscribe for more such content. So, thank you so much for your time. I'll see you in the next one.